Hello, everyone. It is Saturday, October 19th in the year of our Lord 2013. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. Cinema Saturday, one of my all-time favorite movies ever. If you know this song that began this movie from 1989, then you know the movie. Harlem Nights, baby. Today will be a little different. We'll have some of the music and some of the, lot of sound bites as well. I think you're really going to enjoy that, folks. So let's get cracking, because today's show is brought to you by my good friends over at thesportsstuff.com. My man, Dylan Richardson. Oh my God, I drew a blank. Thesportsstuff.com, Dylan Richardson. He started it, and I got my good friend Alex Reamer. It's on there with his Red Sox podcast. Phenomenal stuff, without a curse. The Sports Stuff, great place to go hang out, talk sports with great people. And there you go. Thesportsstuff.com. Check them out, folks. But I'm parched right now, so let's bring out the proper beer consumption apparatus. Today's beer of the day, boys, girls, and it's, oh yeah, Guinness Black Lager. Out of Dublin, Ireland. Good stuff. Proper beer opening apparatus, proper technique. -45 degree right into the beer consumption apparatus, right over the keyboard, because it's that damn good. Haven't spilled a drop yet? Never have, never will. Cheers to beers, all you processed in Germany, goodbye, as they say in Japan. A minus, great stuff. What a song, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Well, before we get to the birthdays, I have got to let you hear this one, folks. This is classic. Started off Harlem 1918.
I got Mr. Raymond Siggery.
Just listen up.
Going in back.
And enjoy. Oh, hell, let's show off the first hunk of the day while we play this one, huh? Why not? Red Fox.
Come on, kid, give me my cigarette.
Such a great movie, folks.
What the fuck is this kid doing in here? Get the hell out of here.
Sorry about the language, folks. Not for the kids. Man, we missed this guy.
I don't care who he is, man. I don't care what he does, man. Kids bring me bad luck, and I don't want them in the room when I'm shooting.
Though the bet is faded, motherfucker. Stop jacking off and shoot the dice. You fucking up the game, man.
Red Fox
Gallery's shit. I told you, phenomenal. Kids bring me bad luck. I can't stand them little bastards. Now get the fuck out of here before I kick your ass.
You ain't whooping shit. Now shoot the dice, you snaggletooth motherfucker.
Damn, I'm gonna shoot the damn dice. You understand? I'm gonna shoot him. I'm gonna send every one of you motherfuckers home. Bro,
shoot him.
Bro.
Oh, shit.
Come on.
Three legends right there, folks.
Come on, yeah. Hey, what the fuck you doing with this kid in here, man?
Rest in peace to them.
Motherfuckers bring me bad luck, man.
Whoa, whoa. What's that sign say? Ray's place. That's me. This is my place, okay? I haven't here who the fuck I want.
1918.
Okay?
Red Fox.
Don't pass the dice. I'll buy them from this motherfucker.
And I ain't selling, punk. I ain't buying either. What I'm gonna do is shoot this shit again, and you're gonna get that kid's ass out of here. That's what's gonna happen.
What the fuck is wrong with you? Wait, man, look. You shot. You lost. I mean, we'd have paid you if you won, but you lost. Now take your big ass home and brush that tooth.
Oh, Richard Pryor.
Think that's funny, huh?
Oh, man.
Huh? I told you I couldn't stand kids in the room when I was shooting. They bring me bad luck, but you wouldn't listen, would you?
I'm listening.
Well, listen to this. I want back all the money I lost tonight.
Sorry about the...
And I want back everything.
A lot of this movie was dark, folks.
You understand me, you smooth-talking son of a bitch? Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Now tell that old frog-faced, gravel-voiced dude to take his slow-walking ass on out there and bring back the money. Tell it. Otherwise, I'm going to stick your ass. And I'm going to stick him, and I'll definitely stick this little janky-ass, bad-luck motherfucker standing here.
I think you don't have to stick us, because I ain't giving you shit.
Yeah.
Wait, before you do, I just want to tell you one thing.
What you want to tell me, huh? Huh?
What the fuck you want to tell me, man? I just, what the fuck
there
you
want
to tell me? It slips my mind.
Slip your mind.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. Jesus Christ. God damn. I guess he does have bad luck with kids.
Oops. I was showing off the Richard Pryor pictures. I didn't even realize it. Oops. We'll get to more of those in a moment. Hell of a scene, eh? That's what I'm talking about. All right. Happy birthday to my man Sean Sampson. Mafia Wars guy, how you doing? Hope you're doing well. And Sean, always a pleasure. Always appreciate the help. I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you, my friend. Hope you enjoy the show. All right. One more and then the next soundbite. And happy birthday, my good friend, Liz Carroll. Known her a long damn time. If I'm not mistaken, fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Reach High School class of 1988. Or was it 89? I think it was 88, though. And Liz, haven't heard from you in a long time. Drop me a line. Let me know how you're doing. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. All right. Next soundbite. All right, you're going to love this. This is the classic fight scene right here between Eddie Murphy.
I think you better go over to Benny's craft table.
Oh, no.
People are complaining about him.
Why?
His glasses.
Never mind.
I got my glasses yesterday.
I know.
I should have played this one a little bit later on, but... Benny Snake Eyes was a red fox. When he had to get his glasses. Can you blame him for not wanting to have to wear those?
That's the seven. Be everybody. All right.
Yeah. You have to see the scene to truly appreciate it.
You look good.
I don't feel no different.
Well, let's try it.
Here we go.
Back with his glasses.
Hey,
fuck yo. All right. Well, here we go. How about 1 o'clock jump count, Basie 1937? Movie set in 1938. How fitting. Great song. One of Count Basie's classics. as we bring out more birthdays. My man Brian Jasek, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Squeeze me. Now, I know Brian because of our great late friend Johnny Vaughn. Brian's a wicked hardcore Chicago Bears fan. Stop Bears. And Brian, happy birthday to you, my friend. Hope you're doing well. And brother, to Johnny, we salute, man. Absolutely. But Brian, have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. And then I got a fellow Masonic brother and a great man, my man Jim Murray. Happy birthday to you, brother. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Jim is the proud owner of a phenomenal restaurant in Falmouth, Massachusetts, known as the Nimrod. I love the name of the restaurant. I love the food. And Jim's a hell of a guy. Hey, Jim, how about that, huh? You know what that is. That's right. Tubal Cane. But, that's right. But anyway, Jim, happy birthday, my friend. Cheers and beers to you. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Go Red Sox. May they close out the series against the Tigers tonight. And the final birthday today goes to a lovely young lady by the name of Britt Best. We know her from jolly old England. She's living in Iowa. And her sister Amber and one of my daughter Delilah's very best friends. Delilah's horseback riding today, but I'm sure she says happy birthday to you, Britt. And how you doing? Hope you're doing well. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and apple juice to you. I know you don't drink adult beverages. And hope you enjoy the show, my friend. And tell the family hello from Farrah and I and Delilah. We definitely miss you big time. And I have a feeling my virus scan is running in the background. It's getting a little choppy. All right, folks. We had some good trivia questions, and I think we should get to those now. Harlem Nights was the last role for which of its stars? Well, our man and hardcore viewer, awesome guy out of Missouri, Mike Taylor, he said Red Fox. And he said at first he beat my man Mike Captain America Long by 2 minutes. Mike, wicked awesome job, Mike Taylor. Hell yeah, brother. Love Dr. Salute to you. Way to go. And your Cardinals are looking good. It's a possibility we could have a Red Sox Cardinals World Series again for the fourth time. Yeah, 1946 and 67, the Cardinals beat my Red Sox in 7 games. Then my Red Sox swept your Cardinals in 2004. Miracle, because that was a phenomenal Cardinals team. One of the greatest baseball teams of all time. And then, 2013, we'll see what happens. Alrighty, well, you know, there's your birthdays and there's your trivia question. Let's bring out the other two real quick. Nobody got them right, but, aw, oh, nice try, though. I mean, in the movie Harlem Nights, how many times is the F-bomb or F-word used? How many times is the word fuck used, okay? And its various derivatives, you know, like motherfucker and stuff like that. Yeah. Believe it or not, only 133 times. I swear it was used a lot more. I could have sworn it was used. Swear. Could have sworn it was used a lot more than 133 times. But apparently not. So 133 times, that's according to IMDb.com, a.k.a. the Internet Movie Database. Had to look that one up. And another question I posted was, in the movie Harlem Nights, what year is it when the movie starts? Well, folks, in the beginning of the movie, set in 1918, and then 20 years later, 1938 for the rest of the movie. Phenomenal, phenomenal movie. Harlem Nights, lots of great stuff. Got lots of great movie facts for you and stuff like that. Right now, what I want to do is I want to bring out another phenomenal soundbite. Oh, this is a classic. One of my favorites, no doubt about that. Let's see here.
Keep your eyes out for the next couple of days, okay?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, here she comes, Della Reese. That's right. The great Della Reese.
Sarah, you know we're tied up at 4 o'clock. What is your problem?
kiss my ass, sugar.
You just need to listen to watch for the next 5 minutes.
Until the last trick is gone. And I'm not about to ask no customer to roll over so I can punch some goddamn clock.
It's funny because she's place, about Christian.
I am in charge of the girls.
And yet, she was so different in this movie.
Stop it, sugar.
It had to have taken a lot for her to swear the way she did in this movie.
We made about 200.
200?
Your girl's been back there all night. How'd they only make $200? You kissed my ass quick.
That's Eddie Murphy.
I'll never say nothing to you when the crap table and the bar come up short. Because the bar and the crap table never come up short, just a girl.
Now calm down, Vera.
Kiss my ass, sugar. I want to know what it is Quick is trying to say.
Let's show off Richard Pryor real quick. Our second hunk of the
girl,
day.
Right? I am in charge of the girl.
Are you in charge of the girl?
I am in charge of the girl.
Okay, the girls are always coming up short. All right, let's get the shit out in the open. The girls are always coming up short. Even when the place is packed, the girls come up short. Now, either you or them got a problem with their arithmetic.
Are you saying I'm stealing?
Man, they say you're stealing, girl. Now, come on over here and sit down and shut the fuck up.
You shut the fuck up, Benny. I would tell you to kiss my ass, too, but you probably can't find it, you blind motherfucker.
Fuck you, bitch.
Me and you got to step out back.
Uh-oh. Hey, it was just a misunderstanding.
No, it ain't. It ain't no misunderstanding. Quick just accused me of stealing. And if you're going to take up for Quick in here, we can all be some fighting motherfuckers in here this evening. Bring your ass, nigga. Bring it on. Come on. Bring your ass. Come on, get up and come on, motherfucker.
I
want
to see Quick
getting the movie. I want to
see this too.
Come on, Quick, don't get up. All right, bitch, you want to fight? We can fight then. You fat motherfucker, I'm tired of your shit.
Jack Jenkins.
I'm going to beat the shit out of your ass. And you, oh, Jesus. No, no, hold me, sugar. No, let me go, sugar. Let me go.
Watch your ass.
Stop taking
the
homie!
You better watch
it
quick, you fucking with
a
heavyweight!
Uh-oh. There's Delarice with the cool crew. Red Fox, Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy. This was a phenomenal movie, folks.
Come on!
That famous Eddie Murphy laugh.
He's
a brain cell lamb Yankee fan.
You wanna fight? Well then come on, goddammit. It's been fucking me since I'ma beat the shit out of your old ass in this motherfucker too.
Breckenridge. Avalanche. Amber style ale. 4.4% a little weaker than average, but that's okay. Good flavor.
And I'ma blast your motherfucking nigga, you hit like a bitch.
Oh,
you little slow than you thought, ain't you, huh? Yeah. I punch like a bitch, huh? Okay, I punch like I
Rock beer opening up brass pump technique.
Right now.
That wow! Love it. She whooped his ass.
You're gonna have to learn
45 degree angle in the big assumption.
Me.
Apparatus. And the keyboard. That is that damn good.
And the next time you accuse me of stealing, I'm gonna kick your ass again.
Ooh, boy. Hey, you gonna fuck with a big old black one. I'll tell you that right now. That sister whooped that ass.
You crazy bitch.
Cheers to bears, all you.
Oh, you wanna hit people with garbage cans. Now I got to cut you.
Uh-oh. Cheers to bears, all you process in Germany, fires they say in Japan.
I ain't playing no more. You put that fucking razor away, I'ma blow your goddamn pinky toe off.
Yeah.
Oh, now you're gonna shoot me in my pinky toe.
I'm not playing with you. I will blow that little black, gnarled, crusty, dead motherfucker the fuck off your foot. Now put the razor away.
You must be crazy to pull your gun on me.
Oh, boy.
You're going to be the nine-toe having this living this bitch in Harlem if you don't stop fucking with me. Now put the razor away.
Well, go ahead. Shoot, it is. There it is. Shoot. Quick, go ahead. Take your best shot.
Oh my god, I've watched this movie like millions of times and I still laugh every time I watch it. Let's get some additional shout outs out there as we listen to Take the A Train, Duke Ellington, 1941. I know the song's actually a little bit newer than when the movie's set. It's Hollywood, don't blame me. Great song though. Let's give some love to my good friends Matt and his better half Don Fleischens. We're gonna be hanging out with you tonight, going to Rose's Cafe down here in Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. And you guys are moving to Missouri, or as they like to call it up there, Missouri, the Show Me State. Matt, I've known you for over 20 years. I've known you for 21 years, man. Gonna miss the hell out of you. No doubt about it. And Dawn, total sweetheart all the way. I've known you for over a decade now. And you guys are phenomenal. We miss you. We're going to miss you. We love you. And you better stay in touch. All right? And don't forget, you can always come back down here to Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Western Louisiana, and visit. Okay? The door is always open for the two of you. You're always welcome at Casa de Love Goddess. Cheers and beers to both of you. And you will be sorely missed. My man Jeff Fontaine. Dude, you and I used to watch this movie all the time. And I want to give a shout out to you. Badass Crudo. Detail Mafia for life. And Stylifter, you know it. He's living in Springfield, Massachusetts. West Springfield, Agawam. And Jeff and his gorgeous better half Maria, the ageless wonder that she is. Jeff, so awesome hanging out with you back in February. We're going to hang out again, man. But you guys are always welcome to come back down here to Yeehaw, Texas to visit us, down, otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Ha! Remember those Mexico trips, don't you? Oh, yeah, Tijuana. Oh, good times, Jeff. Well, hey, man, want to give you a shout-out and say, what up, cuz? Live, doctor. And cheers and beers to you. Hope you enjoy the show. And the final shout-out of the day I'm going to give to my man, Jeremy Luth. Another one of those badass Chicago Bears fans. Stop Bears. A badass Jack God I worked with in jolly old England. And Jeremy, what up, man? The pride of Iowa. He's from Iowa. And a damn good man indeed. And Jeremy, hope you enjoyed today's show. And brother, much respect. Cheers and beers. Bring out some movie facts for you. You know that this film was made because Eddie Murphy always wanted to direct and act in a period piece. Period piece, basically, you know, not set in the current era. Moreover, Murphy had always wanted to work with Richard Pryor, whom Murphy had considered to be the greatest influence on his work in stand-up comedy. Which is ironic. Red Fox influenced the Richard Pryor. Richard Pryor influenced the Eddie Murphy. Folks, that's why this movie is so special. Because it's got like the three generations of badass black comedians. I mean, my God. Incredible. In fact, by his own admission, Eddie Murphy felt that he didn't dedicate enough thought or care to the directing of his debut. He was more concerned at the time with figuring out where the next party was going to be. Yay, he was, 28 years old when he did this movie. So he was still a big kid and partying up. He's definitely mellowed out over the years. And, you know, it's funny because he used to make fun of Bill Cosby about how Bill Cosby was so mellow and laid back and, you know, didn't swear or nothing. And now, ironically, Eddie Murphy's the same way as what Bill Cosby was back in the day. Pretty crazy how that happened, but it's true. You grow up. Eddie Murphy once said that the jokes and camaraderie between him, Richard Pryor, Red Fox, Robin Martin, back then there was Robin Harris and Della Reese behind the scenes was much funnier than anything that was in the film. Oh, God. If that's true, and I thought the film was an absolute riot. Can you imagine the stuff that they were saying? Oh, man. Speaking of the film, here you go. Here's a good movie clip for you. Let's just chill. Oh! Another great scene. This is the only part of the movie that Arsenio Hall was in. Although Arsenio Hall I'm not using as a hunk of the day because he was only a bit part. I'll tell you what, the 5 minutes that he had in this movie was phenomenal. Quick! He was funny. This scene is legendary, folks. Just listen up. Tommy gun, hell yeah.
Brother,
there you go. There's Arsenio. And then that little pea shooter. The only movie where Eddie Murphy, Richard Pryor, Red Fox all star in one film. In fact, it's the only movie that any two of them star in together, let alone all three. Did you hear that?
No! I think I broke my nose!
Three generations of African American comedies and comics. You may hear all 133 fucks in the same movie on this show. First Eddie Murphy movie with a predominantly black slash African American cast. How about that? Seems nuts, folks. Movie was filmed between April and July 1989. As we said, final cinema movie of actor comedian Red Fox. Uh-oh.
Doing that little shit.
Three shots. Boom. Three shots, three dead motherfuckers. Just like that. Well, that's interesting. Information about my video from Beer and Song of the Day, April 13, 2013. Now, all of a sudden, somebody's decided that they want to make a claim to the copyright of that shit. God, I hate copyright infringement Nazis. They suck. People like that deserve a big fat GFY. I promote music, alright? Jackasses. Alright, speaking of promoting music, let's do it. Oh, before I do that, here's a quick scene that I think you'll enjoy. Jack Jenkins.
How you doing, champ?
Champ.
Yeah. What's going on? Hello, gentlemen, lady. How's everybody doing this evening?
We're doing fine.
What happens when you box too much?
You ready for next week?
Ready? Yeah. Yeah.
I'm
ready.
Hey, I'm having a lot of money on you, man.
Well, you getting ready to be a rich nigga, you see, cause next week, I'm knocking somebody the fuck out. You understand.
Wait,
I understand now. It took a while, but I got it.
Well, you peoples enjoy your meals.
Peoples.
Come on, babies.
Alright, folks. It's time to bring out one hot, hot woman. Our first babe of the day. One of my favorite babes of all time. The lovely, gorgeous, wicked, awesome Layla Rochon, who played Sunshine. Kids, block your ears. You know, I remember Red Fox saying, I remember Della Reese saying, I got a girl whose pussy's so good you can throw it up in the air and call it Sunshine. And that's where we're talking about her. Layla Rochon. And Red Fox like, How about let's play Just One More Chance by Billie Holiday. Oh, beautiful song for a beautiful woman. For a beautiful film. Good God. Sadly, I had trouble getting a lot of pictures of, we had our admins, Big McLeod, Huge, and Gidget. And we all had a challenge getting a lot of pictures from the movie. For whatever reason.
Ooh, it's you alone.
We did what we could. But we're going to show some good stuff as well.
Each
man. Layla Rochon, if that ain't fine, I don't know what is, folks.
Just one more chance.
That woman's so fine, I'd drink her bath water if I was single, of course.
Just one more.
Tell you, she was fine then, she's fine now.
Taste the kisses that enchant me.
I can't help but think of when I see her, I just want to yell out like Randy Watson, played by Eddie Murphy in Coming to America. Sexual chocolate! Sexual chocolate! Because man, that is sexual chocolate all the way right there, folks. If that ain't gorgeous. Good God. Layla Rochon, definitely finer than a new set of snow tires. One of the most beautiful women I think I've ever seen in my life. I already showed that one. Yowza, that smile. That Oscar-winning smile. Good Lord.
Still I'm hoping all the while.
Layla Rochon. And she's got jugs, too. Yeah.
Just one more
word. Look at that woman, huh? Good God. That's a fine specimen of beauty right there.
But now I'm
older there. Older and bolder and still badass as can be. Yeah. Never lost that smile. Ever. Oh, what a song for a, what a hot woman. There you go. Here's a scene from Harlem Nights. That's where I fell in love with her. 1989, folks. If that ain't gorgeous, I don't know what is. Wow.
I know that I should serve my sentence.
That's her nowadays, folks. Look at her. Nowadays, okay? It's actually from 2012, last year. Still fine. Finer than a new set of snow tires.
Yes, one more.
This woman's amazing. Leela Rashawn. Oh, but good God, look at her there, will you?
Except that I was glad to start out. But now I'm back to
cry. Oh, baby! Oh, my God! Leela, where have you been all my life, girl? Where have you been all my life? Like James Brown always said, good God. Man, that's one fine ass woman right here. I'll show that one again. Why not? Damn. Good God. Alrighty. Well, shit. Folks, let's get to some more movie facts as we bring out a classic from 1931-32. It don't mean a swing. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Duke Ellington. Lots of Duke Ellington songs in the movie, by the way. Boy, soundtrack in this movie was incredible. Just sad as hard to find. An unnamed actress in the film sued Eddie Murphy for $75 million for alleged sexual harassment. The suit was unsuccessful. Interesting. Like I said, it's the only movie that Eddie Murphy directed. The nickname of Vernus Brown, played by Eddie Murphy, was Quick, while the nickname of Benny Wilson, played by Red Fox, was Snake Eyes. According to TV Tropes, after this movie's failure, Eddie Murphy's career wouldn't recover until the 1996 remake of The Nutty Professor. Yeah, Hollywood and the critics gave this movie bad reviews. I think people who smoke crack and deserve a GFY for that shit. This movie was phenomenal, folks. I cannot believe the poor ratings this movie got. The name of the After Hours 1930s Harlem nightclub was Club Sugar Ray. Of course, Sugar Ray, Richard Pryor. Eddie Murphy was the film's director, executive producer, sole credited writer, top billed lead actor, and star. Wow. Of course, we had Danny Aiello, Michael Lerner, Della Reese, Red Fox, Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy. I mean, my goodness. Phenomenal cast, no doubt about it. The movie soundtrack featured seven classic tracks, like this one, by Duke Ellington. Black Beauty, Moon, Indigo, Take the A-Train, The Gal from Joe's, Sophisticated Lady, Drop Me Off in Harlem, and of course this one, It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing. Now, the film got an Academy Award nomination for Best Costume Design, but failed to win the Oscar. But failed to win the Oscar in this category, with the prize going to the historical outfits for William Shakespeare's Henry V. And, sadly, both Eddie Murphy and the movie combined receiving two Gold Raspberry Award nominations for the film for Worst Director and Worst Screenplay. Eddie Murphy and the movie won for the worst screenplay ever. Oh, for the year. Gold Raspberry Awards are for the worst. Wow. Now check this out. Reportedly, actor-comedian Richard Pryor once said that the film's development and pre-production period that the potential had guys in Hollywood putting money down on new Porsches and vacation homes. Yeah, they thought this movie was going to be bigger than it was. I thought it would, too. To me, it was big, but apparently, I don't know, I guess people were stuck on stupid. Yep, LA Times called the film as a buddy-buddy-buddy movie. Three generations of African-American comics in lead roles, and I think that was huge. I really do. All right, folks, let's see here. What do we got? What the hell? Somebody's knocking on the door. Well, I'm not getting it. Long time no see, huh? Yeah, let's play it. Why not? The Andrews Sisters, 1939. Let's get into some other celebrity birthdays. Trey Parker. 44 years old today, Trey Parker with Matt Stone, of course, from, they brought us South Park, which is still going strong. Robert Reed, born this day in 1932, passed away in 1992, of course, Mike Brady on the Brady Bunch, the father. Evander, the real deal, Holyfield, 51 years old today. Divine, transgender, 300-pound actor, actress, whatever it was. Born this day, 1945, passed away at the age of 42 in 1988. Famous in the film Hairspray. Jose Bautista, Toronto Blue Jays slugger, badass, 33 years old today. There's a couple people that are 68 years old today, born this day, 1945. John Lithgow, phenomenal actor, Third Rock from the Sun, did a hell of a job in the Twilight Zone movie in 1982-83. And then we got Jeannie C. Riley. Jeannie C. Riley, Harper Valley PTA, 1968. She's famous for that song. Rodney Carrington, and that song's from 1968, the year that Rodney Carrington was born. Rodney Carrington, we love that man. Phenomenal stand-up country comedian and music artist. 45 years old today. Peter Tosh, legend in reggae with Bob Marley and the Wailers. Had a successful solo career as well. Born this day, 1944. Passed away much too young in 1987. And then finally, psychic Sylvia Brown. I remember watching her many, many times on Montel Williams' show. She's good, folks. She's damn good. Check out psychic Sylvia Brown. She's pretty impressive. 77 years old today, still going strong. Now, according to Gabby Tartakovsky's June 2011 article, Harlem Nights, Eddie Murphy, and the original gangsters of black comedy at the Pop Matters website, Richard Pryor's toning down the Sugar Ray character wasn't scripted as such, and Pryor believes his performance was the result of being bothered with a recent multiple sclerosis diagnosis, which he kept to himself at the time. So in other words, he probably intended to have Sugar Ray a lot more hardcore character, but it was very toned down, but I think he did a hell of a job with it. Yeah, Richard Pryor, of course, diagnosed with MS and sadly passed away from it in 2005 at the age of 65 years old. Very, very sad. We miss him big time. Multiple sclerosis, one of the most god-awful things I think anybody could ever be inflicted with. We know Annette Funicello passed away as well from that just recently, and we miss her. Boy, oh boy. In the autobiography, Pryor Convictions and Other Life Sentences from 1997, Richard Pryor states that he never connected with Eddie Murphy. People talked about how his work had influenced Eddie Murphy, and perhaps it did. Well, he's quoting here. He says, People talked about how my work had influenced Eddie Murphy, and perhaps it did. But I always thought Eddie's comedy was mean. I used to say, Eddie, be a little nice, and that would piss him off. I finished Harlem Nights thinking that Eddie didn't like me. Well, you know what? With Eddie Murphy mellowing out nowadays, I'm willing to bet that Eddie Murphy thinks of Richard Pryor is a true, almost father figure. The guy was phenomenal. So, here you go. How about another sound bite? This one's a great one. I think you'll enjoy this. Listen up.
In the middle cabinet on the third shelf.
That's not hash, it's tuna fish. Oh, shit, make some tuna there. You got to do something about that hash, Benny. You got my mouth all ready for hash and eggs. You ain't got no hash. You can't keep fucking with me that way.
Bitch, please.
Oh, bitch, please, my ass. Well, fat bitch, do you want a sandwich?
The parrot cracks me up.
Man, fat bitch.
Doesn't.
You should have just finished it. Don't put it back in the refrigerator with just a swallow in the container. I get my mouth all set for some orange juice, and it's just a swallow in the container.
Well, swallow it and shut the fuck up.
You lying motherfucker.
You fat bitch. You should go talk to her. Tell her you're sorry.
That parrot. Such a great scene.
You want a sandwich quick?
This movie won the Worst Picture Awards, the 12th Hastings Bad Cinema Society Stinkers Awards in 1989. That is pathetic.
I wish it would happen, never happened. I appreciate everything.
This movie was so much better than it's given credit for. There you go. All right. One more scene, and then we're going to finish strong with Eddie Murphy as Hunk of the Dead. You know what? I'm going to show off Eddie Murphy now as we listen to this. That's what I'm going to do.
Oh, Richie.
Ooh, Lila Rashawn.
You made me so happy. And you know what I do when you still want to see me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Richie. You know, I have to admit, when we first met...
Eddie Murphy. Ooh.
You were?
And when we made love, I held back. Now that I've opened up and I've told you the truth about myself, I just want to be completely free to do any and everything.
Oh, that's Jasmine Guy right there with Eddie Murphy.
Oh, God.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Great outfits in this movie. Sugar Ray.
I think I'm falling in love with you.
Oh, shit. I wish you could say that to me. If I was single, of course. Eddie Murphy. And Richard Pryor. He's about ready to shoot her toe off. That pinky toe.
Yeah. Give me Hollycourt.
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, darling. Put mommy on the phone.
This is crazy.
Yeah,
scene.
Barbara, it's Richie. Yeah, look, I ain't never coming home no more. Take it easy.
Yeah. You know, and there's a part where Red Fox later says, "Man, you know that gotta be some good pussy to make a man change gods," where Richie changes from Catholic to Baptist.
Yeah,
That's a good pussy make a man change gods. That's the way he put it. I always thought that was a classic line. I couldn't find that one in the movie, so I had to throw it out there. On this day in 1987, Black Monday happened as Dow Jones Industrial went down 508.32 points, 22% decrease, four times the previous record. Wow. On this day in 1980, Steve McPeak rides a 101-foot, 9-inch unicycle. On this day in 1975, Chorus Line opens at Schubert Theater, New York City for 6,137 performances. On this day in 1960, Happy Independence Day to Mauritania as they gain independence from France. On this day in 1941, first woman jockey in North America, Anna Lee Wiley in Mexico. On this day in 1926, John C. Garand patents the semi-automatic rifle. On this day in 1914, U.S. Post Office first used an automobile to collect and deliver mail. Cool. On his day in 1856, do you think Jack Jenkins had it bad in Harlem Nights? Try this one. James Kelly and Jack Smith fight bare knuckle for 6 hours and 15 minutes in Melbourne, Australia. Jeez. On his day in 1781, General Cornwallis surrenders at Yorktown at 2 p.m. as the Revolutionary War ends. Freedom! America! Hell yeah! And finally, on his day in 1722, French C. Hopfer patents the fire extinguisher. Let's finish strong, folks, with a hot woman and a hot song. Drop Me Off at Harlem, Louis Armstrong. As this one closes the movie, we're going to close with the gorgeous, wicked, awesome Jasmine Guy, smoking hot. Oh, I will say, she hasn't aged as well nowadays as one Lila Rashawn, but she's a pretty damn good looking woman in her own right, with a body to rock. What a song. Smoking. Those cigarette holders. They crack me up. Damn, she looked good there, though. And I remember her in a different world. Big old tough guy, you know, you got a good Italian tough guy, eh? Louis Armstrong, what a legend he was. There's two colors enough in Harlem. He writes all his tunes in Harlem. And old Satchmo's still swinging. Way up in Harlem. Louis Satchmo Armstrong. They're beating out those rips. And the Palo, Puerto Rico. Yeah, we'll show that again. Why not, eh? Yes. Drop me off in Harlem. Hey, Jasmine Guy looked good there, huh? So nowadays, face isn't the best, but the body, good God, she has kept that body amazing. Yeah, she looked good there, though, nowadays. Lovely smile, older and bolder, banging body. But oh, Lila Rashawn, though, ooh boy, I could look at that all day. The Jasmine Guy, pretty fly herself. There you go, folks, there you go. And I'll drink to that. Empty as a brain cells of the average Yankee fan, folks. Phone is blowing up. Let's see what we got here on. Oh. Mafia Wars post. Folks! You know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, It's time to make a fetus and head out. So everybody take care. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spill your drink. Or you might kill yourself. Or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. And what's dumber than that is rooting for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli.
Oh, I'm as good as Tom Brady.
And yet you're 0-6. Manning. Or men slapping women. Or animal abuse. Or racism. Or people that welch on bets. Or fake friends. Or anybody that supports, defends, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big, fat, GFY. Folks, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Go Red Sox. Take care of those Tigers tonight, please. Please, please, please. Holler at you tomorrow. What did I say? Holler at you all tomorrow.